Hi everybody and welcome. My name is Luke and this is The Science Lens, where I show you how science can improve your critical thinking skills. In today's episode, we're talking about the availability bias. Recently, I did a rewatch of some old episodes of Scrubs. Now, if you don't know the show, it's a comedy about a group of doctors and nurses that work in a teaching hospital. At the start of the episode called My Life in Four Cameras, JD, Turk, and Carla are all watching the news.
With 27 deaths so far, this strain of E. coli from tainted meat is quite serious. So if you're a big meat eater, be careful.
The reason we were upset was that every time the media reports on some weird health crisis, everyone who sees it thinks they have it.
Oh, it's not so bad. It's only a few people here.
In this clip, the people rushing to the hospital all overestimated their odds of having E. coli poisoning because they'd just seen a story about it in the news. Now, this is a textbook example of something called the availability bias, and unfortunately for the team at Sacred Heart Hospital, it's a very common bias. People tend to base their judgments on information that comes to mind easily. So if people can easily think of something such as E. coli poisoning, they tend to think it's more common than it really is. Imagine a person that went to see the movie Jaws and then they went to the beach. Well, they might hesitate to go swimming because they're worried about being attacked by a shark. In this case, it's easy for the person to picture a shark attack because they just saw a bunch of them in the movie. And this makes them think that shark attacks are more common than they actually are. It's called the availability bias because we're using information that's easily available to our minds. It's important to be aware of this bias because it can have some really negative effects. Aside from causing unnecessary anxiety, focusing on unlikely events can distract us from more likely but equally dangerous events, such as drowning or getting in a car accident on the way to the beach. It could affect a person's health if, say, they decide not to take a certain medication because they heard a friend of a friend had a bad reaction to it. And it can also cost you money if a friend winning the lottery makes you go out and buy a bunch of tickets because it seems more likely that you'll win. Or maybe you'll buy an insurance policy that you don't need because the company's website had pictures of burnt down houses and floods. So now that we know that the availability bias exists, how can we use scientific thinking to overcome it? Well, this is becoming a bit of a catchphrase of mine, but the first step is to look at the data. Our brains are magnificent machines, but they're also squishy and unreliable. So to avoid letting a dramatic news story hijack our thinking, we need to look at the cold, hard facts. Make sure the data is relevant. Sometimes when we look at statistics, they can be a little too general. For example, if I looked up the average number of bear attacks that occur annually, I might think there's a chance that it could happen to me. But I'm Australian and we don't have bears, and so unless I jump into the bear enclosure at the zoo, my odds of being attacked are zero. Ask someone to provide a different perspective. Since different people have different experiences, it's possible that another person didn't see Jaws and would have a different, less biased viewpoint on your odds of being attacked by a shark. So when my wife was young, she had a friend that had been infected by this certain type of amoeba that can cause encephalitis. Now, she didn't actually develop encephalitis, thankfully, but to be safe, the doctors had to put a camera down her nose to see the extent of the infection. She described this whole process to my wife, and it really freaked her out. So for the next week, when she went whitewater rafting, all she could focus on was keeping her mouth closed so she wouldn't accidentally swallow some water with the amoeba in it. So how could my wife have thought more critically about her odds of being infected by this amoeba? Well, firstly, she could have looked up the number of people that are infected with this amoeba, which, according to this data from the CDC, is on average 2.55 per year. Now, as a comparison, the website TripSavvy notes that between 2007 and 2016, the average annual deaths from whitewater rafting was around 53. So my wife probably should have been more worried about the rafting than the bugs in the water. Next, she should have thought about the relevance of that data to her situation. So this set of data shows the time of year during which infections occurred and the likely location of infection. Now, as you can see, most infections are contracted in lakes, ponds, and reservoirs, and there are actually very few recorded cases from river water. She also needn't have been worried if she was in the water any month from October to June. Finally, she could have asked someone for a different perspective. My wife's fear came about because of a conversation she had with a friend, so if she'd asked a third person if they were worried about their brain getting eaten by microbes in the water, their response might have been, what? No, is that a real thing? Now, the availability bias is so common that you're never going to be able to avoid it completely. But if you're ever making a big decision, this thinking exercise will help you to make sure that it's based on evidence and not just some example that stands out in your mind. Well, that's it for today's video. I'm going to go for a walk, although I did just read about how many people die from coconuts falling on their head, so maybe it'll be safer to stay inside. If you'd like some resources to help you practice the concepts that I covered today, you should check out my store on Teachers Pay Teachers. There I have a range of resources for teaching critical thinking skills in the science classroom. You can find the link down below in the description. Also, if you enjoyed today's video, please click the like button and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos on how science can help improve your critical thinking. I've also included in the description some links to other resources that I found helpful in putting together this video, so be sure to check them out for more information. For now, that's it from me. Thanks for watching.